Nothing is impossible when you put your mind, heart, soul, and sweat into it. Have a great morning. With this beautiful quotation, we'll start our lesson today. Okay, that basic 256 subroutines and string functions. Almost all string functions we have learned, and subroutines also previous class we have started. One or two program we have already done. So today some other advantages of subroutines we'll learn, and some programs I'll do and show you. Okay. So what are the advantages of using a subroutine? Subroutine means, you remember, it is a small program which can be used in a program. Okay. And you, once a subroutine is formed or developed, that can be called or that can be used in the program many times. Okay. So multiple calls to a block of code are possible at different types in the times in the program. Chances of typing error are reduced, makes the program easy to read as the main steps can be easily followed. Programs are easier to design since the main steps are written. When more than one programmer works on a program, each programmer can choose a subroutine to write independently and also test it. Thereafter, the subroutines can be called in the desired sequence. More than one programmer means, suppose when a big program designed. Okay. So that times what happened, that work distributed among different programmers. Individually, all the programmers work in a part of the program. Later on, they combined all the parts to make that big program. Okay. So that is the benefit of subroutine, means they develop part of one program partly, and at last all the parts are combined together. Clear? So these are the advantages of subroutine. So let us today do some programs using subroutine. Okay, small programs. Now I'll do and show you. So what is this? Another one thing is there. A subroutine can be defined anywhere in the program, but should not be defined inside another subroutine or loop. So write all the subroutine after the end statement. The end statement is used to end the program. Okay. So now see how we can do. So let us come to the basic, and there I'll do the program and show you. Okay. Small program, suppose today previous class I have shown you how to print natural numbers from 1 to 10. Now today I'll show you the even numbers. Okay. Suppose even numbers from 1 to 10. Suppose I am writing here, you see, I is equal to 2, because for the first even number is 2. So writing for I is equal to 2 to 10, step 2. Okay. So here you write go sub, means whenever you want to call a subroutine, you have to write go sub. Okay. Suppose the subroutine name is here, printfn. You can write anything, printfn you can write, here printfn numbers also, you can write any name here, okay. And then, suppose here I am writing next I, here I have written end. End is used to end the program. So here the program ended, and after that I will write the subroutine. So what is the subroutine name here? Printfn. Okay, so two columns. What I want to do, I want to print the even number. So the all the even numbers is stored in I now. Okay, then you write return. I told you in the previous class, that means program always runs sequentially, line by line. So for the one value of I, it will come go sub printfn, and it will search where the printfn subroutine is defined. To that point, it will jump. Okay. So here it is written print I. So it will return, and it will say next I is there. Means the value of I will change from 2 to 4. Okay. So now see the output, you can understand. So what are the outputs? See 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. All the even numbers starting from 2 to 10. Okay. So this way you can print all the even numbers. Any sequence you can print. Suppose if you want to print the odd numbers, then I will start it from first odd number is I. So the value of I will be 1 to 10. Okay. So instead of a print even, I will give the name here as print odd. Okay. So I will define here print out, you can understand this all we have done in QBasic. Okay, just the syntax is different. Okay, so run. See, all the odd numbers printed 1, 3, 5, 7, 9 between 1 to 10. Suppose you want to print the odd numbers in the backward manner, means 10 to 1. So let us make I is equal to 10 starting. Okay, so it will start from 10 and it will go up to 1. So when I'll start from 10 and I'll go up to 1, then the step will be minus 2 then. Okay, so now see what is the output getting at. Okay, so first I got the even numbers because I have started from 10. So that's why I got the even numbers. Let us make it 9. Okay, because 10 to 1, the first odd number is a 9. So now see. Oh, sorry. Here I have to also make the change. 9 to 1. And see, this is all the odd numbers from 10 to 1. Okay. This way you can do the even numbers also. So you just see what I have done. The starting value will be there. End value will be there, but it will the initial position, then final position. Then the step value. Step value means what will be the next value. That is your step value. Then goes up whenever you want to write a subroutine, the goes up will be right. Then you will give a subroutine name. Okay. Then you will define the subroutine and what you want to do inside the subroutine you will write. Then you will write return. When you will return, that return statement will go to this next statement after the subroutine. Suppose, see, if I will clear here the end statement, what output I am getting, see. So, one minus one is there. Means it is going one step forward. Then it is a extra minus one is also coming. So, without end, if you write one step forward, it will go without end. And if end you will write exact value it will store. Actually previous class one query was there that why that has incremented one step. And because I have not used end statement. Okay. So if you will write end then at the exact value it will stop. And if you don't write then one step forward it will go then it will stop. Okay. That is the means difference program writing with end statement and without writing end statement. Okay, so now I will show you one more program. Okay, see these all programs today I will give you in assignment. You note down in your copy and you practice. And if you cannot practice, note down in your copy some of the, I have given the Android link, but it's not working in all mobiles. And when school will open, you can practice, no problem. Okay, and just if you will watch, then you can understand also. So another program I will do for you today. So we can write CLS for clear the screen always. Okay. If I'll write CLS and run, then the screen will be output screen will be clear. So now today's most interesting program we'll write, that is our multiplication table. Okay. Multiplication table of any number. Suppose I want to display the multiplication table of 5. So I am taking I is equal to 5. Okay. So what is the multiplication table? Tell me. For I is equal to, I'll start from 1 and I will go to 10 because 5 into 1, 5 is a 1, 5 is 2, 5 is 3, like this you write, no? So step 1, if you'll not write anything, it will go step 1. Okay. Suppose I will write here go sub. One subroutine I will go sub. Here I will write, suppose print table. The name of subroutine is here, print table. Then I will write here next I. Okay. And then I will write here end. The program will be ended here. And then print table. I will define. Okay. Print. Then what to do for the multiplication table of 5. So we'll multiply 5 into 1 is equal to 5. 5 into 2 is equal to 10, like this. So first we'll write here print. 5 will be multiplied every time, so 5 will write. Then 1, 2, 3, 4 up to 10. The value of 1, 2, 3, 4, it will come from I. So, let us multiplication symbol, then I. Okay. So, now you write return. Okay. Now, see the output. it is at a soul, you 5, 10, 15, 20, like this, no? But it is not looking like a multiplication table, no? It is showing as if we have written 10, first 10 multiples of 5. So, how can you convert it to a multiplication table first? So, for that, what we will do? See, this 5, we will modify the just in this print statement, okay? So, for this, I will write how 5 into 5. So, in the means double quote, whatever we want to print, we write it in the double, 5 into. So, it will be in everywhere it will be repeated, no? So, that I have put it in double quote. Then, plus symbol I am using. Plus symbol is to join the strings, okay? So, then it will be, I will print the value of I, okay? Then, a plus symbol, okay? Then, equal to, okay? Then, plus symbol, okay? Then I will write here, what is 5 into I. Okay. Now see how it is, output is coming. See, it is looking like a multiplication table. You don't confuse. Let us see. Everywhere 5, then a multiplication symbol is there up to this. This I have put it in a double. Okay. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 up to 10 is coming. That is the value of I. So, I have printed. Okay. Then an equal to symbol is there. So, equal to symbol, since it is a symbol, I have put it in a double quote. Then 5 into 1. The result is coming by multiplying these two values. So, that I have written 5 into I. Okay. Just format of the print statement. And this plus is used to join just. Okay. To join, because here it is a character, then a number, then a character and a number, so it is joined together to make this format. For that I have used the plus. Okay, so this way you can print the multiplication table. Suppose you have end statement missed, so what output you will get? Suppose without end statement I am running, so 5 into 11, understood? That means one step it will go, means after 10 one step it will go, then it will stop. And but if you write here end statement, end, then program will be stop exact value, means 10 means it will stop at 10. That is the difference between using end statement in a program and without using end statement in a program. Okay. So, hope all of you understand. These all programs I will give you an assignment, you note down in your copy. And try to see these two videos twice or thrice. So, you can, then you can understand. Okay. And hope all of you can understand, because I have also doubt, because since you are not doing practical, but I am trying my best so that you understand the way I am doing and showing you. Okay. So winding up here, have a nice day all of you. Thank you all.